In this class, we will discuss about the biotechnology applications in agriculture. Now, before getting into the topic, let's understand the methods to increase food production. So, there are three options or methods to increase food production. The first one is agrochemical based agriculture. The second one is organic agriculture or organic farming. The third one is genetically engineered crop-based agriculture. In that, first let's understand agrochemical-based agriculture. So here, in this method, we use chemicals to grow crops. To grow the plant, we use chemicals. So when do we use chemicals? In what form we use chemicals? To increase the fertility of the soil, we are using chemical fertilizers. To kill the insects, to protect the crop from the insects, we are using the chemicals insecticides. To protect the crop from pests, we are using chemicals pesticides. So that means what? Overall, we are growing the plants by using chemicals. Such kind of agriculture is known as agrochemical based agriculture. And you people should know that in 1950s and 60s, what happened is in our country, the food production, the crop production has almost tripled. Food production chala increase ayindi, crop production increase ayindi, triple ayindi. And that particular phase is known as green revolution. So we are referring that particular phase as green revolution. Now let's understand what happened in 1960s, why the food production rate was so high. The reason number one is, at that time we were using high yielding varieties. So by conventional plant breeding techniques, you know that when we cross better plants, we get much more better plant. Like if I am crossing a high yielding tomato with a disease resistant tomato plant, so in the next generation, what is the plants we get? The next generation plants would be both high yielding and disease resistant. So atla we have created hybrid varieties. So by using conventional plant breeding techniques, at that time we created high yielding varieties, hybrid varieties we have created. And this was the reason number one. The reason number two, why the food production has increased? Because of using better management practices. Now what are the better management practices at that time we have performed is utilizing the land efficiently. Unna land ni proper ga use cheskunna. The second thing is proper irrigation, fertilization practices. And we have also, performed proper supply of minerals, water to the crop. And because of all these better management practices, the food production has tripled. So this is also one reason among them. And the third important reason is, at that time, we were using extensive use of chemicals. So high amount of chemicals also we were using. So to protect the crop, we were using pesticides, insecticides, and we were also using chemical fertilizers to increase the fertility of the soil. And because of these reasons, in 1960s, the food production has tripled. It was mainly because of the better management practices, and it was mainly because of extensive use of chemicals. Right, the food production increased. But are they? Now let's understand the advantages and disadvantages of agrochemical based agriculture. The advantages are like food production increases. Crop is protected from insects and pests. Yes, because we are using insecticides and pesticides. So these are the main advantages. And at the same time, there are disadvantages as well. Now what are the drawbacks of this method are, it leads to environment pollution, water pollution and food pollution. So because we are using chemicals to grow these crop, it is leading to pollution of the environment, water, food. And when human beings consume and animals consume the products from the crop which is grown by using chemicals, we are prone to various sort of diseases. That is a very important drawback of this method. And second important thing which you have to know is the chemicals are also expensive. See, the chemicals are very expensive. A common man cannot afford to the expensive chemicals. So these are the main disadvantages of this agrochemical based agriculture. And you know that India, so day by day the population is increasing. So with the growing population in the country, there is a demand for the food production is also high. But the existing varieties and also the expensive chemicals could not able to produce the high yield, high food production, which is required for the high demand for the population. So that is a very important drawback. Now let's go with the second method. The second method of food production is organic farming or organic agriculture. The second method is organic farming or organic agriculture. So here we grow crops by using, we grow plants by using organic manure. Organic manure is like what? Animal waste, plant waste, animal waste, cattle dung, plant waste, animal waste. So by using this animal waste, cattle dung, plant waste, this is all the organic material, right? So by using that manure, we are growing these plants. Now, what is the advantage? The advantage is there would be no side effects when we consume the products of this crop because we are not using the harmful chemicals. Here we are using organic manure. And second important thing is even to kill the insects or pests, we are using some organic chemicals. We are using biopesticides. We are using bioinsecticides. That means what? We are performing some natural method. Biopesticides. These are the living organisms which can kill harmful pests. Bioinsecticides. These are the insect. You know, these are the organisms which can kill harmful insects. So that means what? By using certain techniques, biopesticides, bioinsecticides, organic chemicals, and using organic manure, we are growing the crop. Now, no doubt, this type of organic agriculture has many advantages. The advantages are what? So there would be no pollution. So there is no environment pollution, no water pollution, no food pollution. So you can see that there is no poison in the food. That means what? The food is quality. You can observe that there is a quality in the food. Not only quality, you can see that there would be no chemicals, harmful chemicals in the food. So it is poison free. Poison free food is also obtained by this kind of crops. So organic agriculture is very beneficial. Because these are all organic methods to increase the crop production. But what is the major disadvantage is, yes, there is no high food production. Organic farming lo advantages unnai. Quality undi, food quality. Food lo elanti harmful chemicals undo. And there is no harm to the environment, no harm to the water, no harm to the, you know, food, nothing. So that means what? You can say that organic agriculture has lot of benefits. Benefits sunna hai. But here what is the major drawback is the quantity. So here there is a less quantity or less yield or less crop production can be seen. This is the major disadvantage. Ilanti organic farming valla yield anedi peddaga ekkuvaga undadu. So koncham yield mari high population ki high demand untadi, mari high demand ki inta takko production food production anedi cope up cheyaledu. So that is why organic agriculture at this particular time is not much useful. So that is why now we are switching on to the next method, which is genetically engineered crop based agriculture. Now out of those three methods, the third method is going to be very much beneficial, because with the high demand, with the high population, there's a high demand for the food. Now obviously the third method is going to help us.